start, right on top of the forehand. Lovely winner.
Well, if you're Dominic Thiem, that's just too good. You have to, if you force Nadal to play those kinds of shots to win, then that's the best you can do over the course of a match. 3 out of 5 sets here.
Love, Nadal, being watched by Ion Tiriac, amongst others, the Romanian tennis entrepreneur, very much associated with Boris Becker in the early years, and more recently with all those Romanian players, including Simona Halep. He was a very, very happy man yesterday when she finally won her first Grand Slam title. But he has one of the best seats in the house for this final, and Nadal is looking at his... What on earth happened there? Because he served his first double fault of the final.
It wasn't just a double fault. It hit the court first before touching the net. Complete miss hit from the Nadal racket. Trying to get so much additional spin on that shot.
Four all, 15 all. President's box and his connections, Carlos Moyer and Uncle Tony, watching Dominic Thiem push the service return over the baseline. It's 20 years since Moyer won the title here, his one and only Grand Slam, beat Alex Kurecha in the final. Nadal says he was watching at home on television shortly after celebrating his 12th birthday. Quite a relationship between those two, both hailing from the same island. 30-15, Nadal onto the backhand of Thiem. Thiem's return pushes Nadal back behind the baseline. Nadal now playing a forehand to Thiem's single-handed backhand. Slice backhand Nadal. Thiem with a forehand down the line. Nadal's backhand onto the backhand of Thiem. A floaty slice shot, which is punished by Nadal. Cross-court he goes on the forehand.
Well, you just can see the strength of Nadal in that point. It looked like he was on the defense, he was in trouble, and he finds a way to just put that extra bit of pace, will that ball to get the depth that he's able to get on it.
Two game points for Nadal.
When Rafa Nadal led Novak Djokovic by 2-1 overnight, and it was early in the fourth set, and Nadal wanted to get off court because the rain was falling and Djokovic was coming back into the match and enjoying the heavier conditions. They resumed on the Monday and Nadal won the title. But I'm amazed at this, Chandler, given the fact they start the final so late at 3 o'clock.